Let us see the next question. We have been provided with the information about three state of economy. A, B, C means state of economy A is, say, GDP is, let us say, 8%. State of economy B is GDP is 6%. And state of economy, that's the GDP is, let us say, negative 2%, something like that. Probability is provided for the different state of the economy. For security X, the expected return is given. And for security Y, again, the expected rate of return is given to us. Dear students, we have understood that how the return is calculated. It is by taking into account the dividend, taking into account the price change, say these returns are calculated. The following three investors who want to invest as follows. So information is provided for the three investors who want to make investment. Mr. Tendulkar, who want to make investment in security X. How much, whatever the funds that he has, he wants to completely invest in security X. Mrs. Tendulkar in security Y. And Master Tendulkar wants to make investment 50% in X and 50% in Y. You are required to answer following questions. There are three questions provided to us. The first one is return and risk for Mr. Tendulkar. Return and risk for Mrs. Tendulkar and return and risk for Master Tendulkar using Markowitz model. How to make the calculation by using the Markowitz model? We are just going to discuss that in some time period. So the first one is calculation of the return and risk for an investor who has made investment only in security X. How can you make that? How can you measure it? Very simple. Probability into return. That is the way the weighted average return will be found. And that is the expected return from the security X. Then it is X minus X bar. X minus X bar whole squared into probability. Summation of that is variance. And under root of the same is standard deviation. This is the way we are required to make the computation of the risk for making investment in security X. Please write an answer. Calculation of return and risk for Mr. Tendulkar, comma, who has invested in only one security. So in that the calculation will be made like this. Column number 1 is probability. Column number 2 is return. We'll assign X variable to it. Then probability into X. That is the mean return will be found. X minus X bar, then it is X minus X bar whole square into probability. Summation of that is variance and under root of the same is standard deviation. So here probability is 0.40, 0.20 and 0.40. That is the probability. Return is 18. Then it is negative 9, then it is positive 12. That is the way we are required to adopt the weighted average method. So friends, now probability into X. So it is 18 into 0.4. That comes to 7.20. Negative 9 into 0.20. That comes to 1.8 negative. 12 into 0.40. That comes to 4.8. That is the way we compute the X bar. So what will happen? It is 7.2 minus 1.8 plus 4.8. That comes to 10.2. That is the way the mean return is calculated, 10.2%. Then X minus X bar. So it is 18 minus 10.20. that comes to 7.8 negative. Then it is negative 9 minus 10.2, that is negative 19.2. Then it is 12 minus 10.2, that comes to 1.80. This is the way x minus x bar is calculated. Next bit will be negative 7.8 raised to 2, that is 7.8 square into 0.40. Negative 19.20 square into 0.20. Next is 1.80 square into 0.40. This is the way we are required to compute x minus x bar whole square. So square of 7.8 into 0.4. So it is 24.336. Square of 19.2 into 0.20. So 73.728. Next is square of 1.8 into 0.4. That comes to 1.2960. Whatever the total that we have is the variance. That is x minus x bar whole square into probability and summation of the same. 24.336 plus 73.728 plus 1.296. That comes to 99.36. This is the way variance is supposed to be calculated. Then under root of the same is standard deviation. So we'll compute the standard deviation like this. It is under root of the variance. So it is under root of 99.36. That comes to 9.9679% This is the way the standard deviation is calculated for Mr. Tendulkar, who has made investment only in X. The next working is supposed to be made for Mrs. Tendulkar, who has made investment only in security Y. So next working will be like this. Calculation of the return and risk for Mrs. Tendulkar, comma, who has invested in only security Y. In that case, the same process is required to be followed, dear students. Column number 1 is probability. Column number 2 is return of security Y. Third column is probability into Y. Next is Y minus Y bar. Subsequent to that, it is Y minus Y bar whole square into probability and summation of that is variance. This is the way we are required to compute return and risk for Mrs. Tendulkar. So as far as security Y is concerned, for that the information is given like this. The probability is again 40%, then 20%, then 40%. The return from Y would be 10 positive, 11 positive and 9 negative. So 10 into 0.4, that is 4 positive, then 11 into 0.2, that comes to 2.20, negative 9 into 0.4, that comes to 3.6 negative. Based on this, Y bar can be calculated. So it is 4 plus 2.2 minus 3.6, that comes to 2.6%. Then Y minus Y bar, so 10 minus 2.6, that comes to 7.4 positive. Then 11 minus 2.6, that is 8.4 once again positive. Minus 9 minus 2.6, it is 11.6 negative. Then Y minus Y bar whole square into probability, So square of 7.4 into 0.40. So it is 21.904. Square of 8.4 into 0.20. That is 14.112. Then 11.6 negative into 0.40. That is 53.824. So it is negative 11.6 into negative 11.6 into 0.40. And the total of that is the variance. Directly we'll get the variance over here. It is summation probability y minus y bar whole square. So it is 53.824 plus 14.112 plus 21.904. That comes to 89.84. And based on this, we are required to compute the variance, sorry, standard deviation. Standard deviation would be under root of the variance. So under root of probability into y minus y bar whole square. So it is under root of 89.84. So based on that, we will compute the answer. So 9.4784. That is the way we require to make the computation of the standard deviation. So now the third part of the question, wherein we are required to compute return for an investor who has made investment in more than one security. And that is the generally the case that we have. Because you do not say put all your investment in one security only. You always have the spread of the investment that say you make in the different securities. So over here, say they have specified that say you have made investment in more than one security. Then in that case, what is return of that portfolio is required to be calculated, and what is standard deviation of that portfolio is also required to be calculated. So please write an answer. Calculation of the return of portfolio and the risk of portfolio. For Master Tendulkar. Now friends, over here, so there are two methods by which we can do answer. So let us understand both of them. So method number one. Method number one is quite simple. Let us see that in that case how we are required to make the computation of answer. Column number one is again the probability which they have given to us, 424. Now listen me carefully, return, and I'm assigning z variable to the return. Now how I'm calculating return, understand it carefully. See, in the first 40% chances, the return is calculated like this. 18% into 0.5 plus 10% into 0.5. Clear? We understand that say, the weight of security X in your portfolio into return of X plus weight of security Y in the portfolio into return of Y. That is the way we can apply the weighted average formula. So what will happen over here? It is 9 plus 5. That comes to overall 14%. Next, 20% chances. What will happen? It is negative 9 into 0.50 plus 11 into 0.50 once again. So your 50% of the investment has negative return, and another 50% of the investment has positive return. So the overall it comes to 1%. Lastly, another 40% chances that 50% of the portfolio will have a return of 12% positive, and another 50% of your portfolio will have a return of negative 9%. So it is 6 and that is 4.5 negative. So overall it is 1.50. This is the way we are required to make the computation of the return of your portfolio in different probability. Afterwards, the working is very simple, dear students. You can very well understand it is probability into Z. Summation of that is Z bar, that is return of the portfolio. Next is Z minus Z bar. Then it is Z minus Z bar. Next is Z minus Z bar whole square into probability. Summation of that is variance and under root of the same is standard deviation. This is the way we are required to make the computation of the standard deviation of the portfolio. Okay, so now we will have that there are 40% chances that the return is 14%, so it is 5.60. There are 20% chances that the return is 1%, so it is 0.20. Another 40% chances the return is 1.5, that comes to 0.6. So the overall return comes to Z bar, that is return of the portfolio. And you can use a calculator, 5.6 plus 0.2 plus 0.6, that comes to 6.4%. That is RP. RP stands for return of the portfolio when you have made investment in more than one security. Then Z minus Z bar. So we understand that, so here it is 14 minus 6.4. That comes to 7.6 positive. 1 minus 6.4, that is 5.4 negative. 1.50 minus 6.4, that comes to 4.90. Again it is negative. So here Z minus Z bar is calculated, then Z minus Z bar whole square into probability. So square of 7.6 into 0.4. That is 23.104. Square of 5.4 into 0.2. Then square of negative 4.9. Into 0.4. That is 9.604. So 23.104 plus 5.832 plus 9.604. That comes to 38.54. This is the way variance of the portfolio is calculated. Once you make the computation of the variance, then under root of the same is standard deviation. So as far as the standard deviation of the portfolio is concerned, it is under root of the variance. So it is under root of 38.54. And with that, the final answer is 6.2081%. That is the standard deviation of the portfolio. Now friends, let us have understanding of the method number 2. Method number 2, in that calculation of return of portfolio and standard deviation of portfolio. Let us have understanding that, say, how to calculate the answer. Heading right down, return of portfolio, that's very simple, friends. Dear students, we have studied a concept like weighted average cost of capital at our intermediate level. In case of the weighted average cost of capital, the calculation is made very simply, wherein we take into account that say what is the proportion in which we have raised our funds and what is the cost of the individual source of finance. We compute weighted average of the same, and that is the weighted average cost of capital. Exactly the same concept is applicable over here. You take into account two things. What is the proportion in which you have made investment in the individual security, and what is the return of the individual security? Weighted average of the same is the return of your portfolio. So return of the portfolio can be calculated like this. Listen me carefully. Security X and security Y. What is the proportion in which you have made investment? It is 50-50 percentage. So 0.50 and 0.50. What is the return from security X? Dear students, we already have calculated the same for Mr. Tendulkar. You can see it is 0.4 into 18, 0.2 into negative 9, 0.4 into 12. The weighted average return that you already have found is 10.2%, that is X bar is 10.2%. For security Y similarly, 0.4 into 10, 0.2 into 11, negative 9 into 0.4, that comes to 2.6% positive. That's it. Yes, what you have to do, friends, now weight into return. There are 50% of your investment which is going to generate a return of 10.2%, and another 50% of your investment is going to give a return of 2.6%. So this is 5.10, this is 1.30, and based on that, so the return of the portfolio is calculated, which is 6.40. That is the way the return of the portfolio can be calculated. Please write an answer. This is the way return of the portfolio can be calculated as simple weighted average. You might have made investment in 2 securities, 3 securities, 4 securities, or any number of securities. The simple weighted average is return of your portfolio. So write down a note for the answer. Return of portfolio is calculated as simple weighted average comma similar to weighted average cost of capital. First off, taking into account proportion in which investment is made and return from individual investment. Full stop. Now friends, before we make the calculation of the risk of the portfolio, when you have made investment in more than one security, I would like to have some discussion with you. Let us assume that there are two investors who are making investment in, like Mr. X and Mr. Y, two investors who are making investment like this. Mr. X is making investment in two securities, A and B, as far as the company A is concerned, say it is manufacturing umbrella, and Mr. B is concerned, say he is B company is concerned, it is manufacturing raincoat. Mr. Y is again making investment in two securities. One is security P and another is security Q. Security P, that is say the company P is say dealing in the business of manufacturing clothes, that is say the woolen clothes. And security Q is say dealing in say manufacturing say the cotton clothes. Okay. Like that, say these two investors have made investment in these two securities. Just for the purpose of understanding, let us say that say the return of A and return of P are same. Return of B and the return of Q are same. Standard deviation of A and standard deviation of P are same. Standard deviation of B and standard deviation of Q are same. Keeping all these things same. Now, my question to all of you is this, that say between these two investors, which investor will have more risk in their portfolio? Between these two investors, say which investor will have more risk in portfolio? I want you to give answer for the same in chat box. See friends, over here we understand that say basically we are focusing on the risk. Now for the risk we have to understand that say what kind of return that say these two securities will have in a particular situation. We can understand that say one company which is manufacturing umbrella and another company which is manufacturing raincoat. Both the companies will be able to have good return if at all there is heavy rain. If at all there is a drought situation, then in that case both the companies will not be able to have the business. So can we say that say these two securities will be having say the return if at all say the rain is good, otherwise say the return will be less if at all, or we can say negative if the rain is not good. So volatility of the return will be very high in this case. If at all you make investment in these two securities, then what will happen? If at all summer season is there for a longer period, then security Q will be able to give return and P will not be able to give return, because P is dealing in a, that is say, in a product say which cannot be sold if at all the summer season is for a longer period. Reverse, if at all winter season is for a longer period, then in that case say the P company will be able to have good business and P security will be able to generate good return in your portfolio in comparison to Q. So we can say that say over here comparatively, so the volatility will be less. So over here we will be having say the volatility like this. That is the kind of difference that say we will have over here. So of course if at all you make investment in security P and Q will have less risk in comparison with A and B. So answer to my question that say which combination will have more risk is A and B. That is what we understand. Dear students, what I want to tell you with the above example, that say whenever you are required to compute the risk of your portfolio, then in that case you have to see that what kind of relationship that say the returns of all these securities have with one another, which have been included in your portfolio. You have to see that say what kind of risk that you have, what kind of correlation coefficient that you have, say in, that is say among the securities, say with one another, in order to compute the risk of your portfolio. I'll give you one more example, say to explain you. Suppose say one of my friend is say approaching me and he is say telling me that say Maulid, I want to make an investment of an amount of rupees, let us say 10 lakhs. I'm just confused that should I make investment in a single security or should I make investment in 10 securities? I'm basically confused that say, how should I spread my investment? Only over one security or over 10 securities? Then what should I advise him? So we understand that say, always say you should spread your investment over more than one security. That is the reason I told him that say you should invest in 10 securities. Now my friend is say, approaching to me after 1 year, and he that is say, has a complaint that say, Maulin, I followed your advice and I have incurred a huge loss in my portfolio. That is what's a kind of complaint that say, he made to me. I just inquired that say, did you make investment in 10 securities? He says that say, yes, I made investment in 10 securities, but even though I made a huge loss in the portfolio. Then I inquired further that say, where did you make investment? He told me that say, I made investment in all the securities say, that were belonging to IT sector. And unfortunately, say, recent announcement say, of the central government is adverse for the IT sector. So all my securities value have gone down in the market and I'm incurring a huge loss. That is what say, he told to me. Then I replied him that, see, my dear friend, I wanted to tell you that say, you should make investment not only in the number 10. You should make investment in the 10 securities, and preferably they should be belonging to the different sectors. You should make investment in pharma sector. You should make investment in banking sector, fast moving consumer goods company, then IT sector. Like that, so you should make investment in the different securities, say belonging to the different sectors. Because what will happen, say at one point of time, it will not happen that so the all sectors are falling down. That is the reason, say the poor performance of one of the sector will be compensated with say the good performance of some other factor, that is say other sector. That is the way you will be able to have the hedging of your portfolio. This is what say I told him. So we understand that say diversification is basically you should make investment in the securities say which have preferably negative relationship. So what happens that say the poor performance of one security will be compensated with the good performance of the other security. This is what say we understand. And this is what say I told to my friend. So over here, say for Master Tendulkar, the same thing is applicable. In order to compute standard deviation of his portfolio, risk of his portfolio, we are required to make the computation of the correlation coefficient between returns of security X with returns of security Y. We understand that say the correlation coefficient is say from negative 1 to positive 1. That is a range. Negative 1 is indicating that say these two securities return have perfect negative relationship. 0 is indicating that say both the securities return are independent to one another. And 1 is indicating that say the returns of both of them are having perfect positive relationship. It means that say the percentage change in the return of security X and percentage change in the return of security Y are exactly the same. This is indicating moderate negative and this is indicating moderate positive. That is the way we can have so the 5 different segments of correlation coefficient. That is what we understand. Okay, so read on heading risk of portfolio. In bracket, write down as per Markowitz model, which we are going to learn, say, in some time. In the write down, first point, whenever investment is made in only one security, comma, then return and risk. Of that security is return and risk of portfolio. Second point. If investment is made in more than one security, comma, then return of portfolio is simple weighted average however risk of portfolio is not simple weighted average. Full stop. Third point. In order to compute standard deviation slash variance of portfolio, comma, we have to consider A, risk of individual security, B, proportion of each security in portfolio and C, correlation coefficient in bracket write down R between all securities with one another. Full stop. Fourth point. We can say that lower R, okay, this is R, correlation coefficient. With that, risk of portfolio will be less and vice versa. In bracket write down example of umbrella, raincoat, full stop. Write down now new heading, formula. In that write down, to compute sigma p square, that is variance of portfolio, for two securities, comma, we can use following formula. So the formula is like this: variance of the portfolio is equal to, for more than two there is a slight modification, but for two, first of all, that, so this is a question, I am giving explanation. Variance of the portfolio is equal to wx square sigma x square plus wy square sigma y square plus 2 into r correlation coefficient into wx sigma x into wy sigma y. This is a simple formula that we have to compute the variance of the portfolio. So let us have understanding of the derivation of the formula. Dear students, this formula is nothing else, but it is a simplification of the working that we already have done in method number 1. See, dear students, we already have done method number 1, wherein variance of the portfolio is calculated like this. So if at all I am writing this in a formula term, just to give explanation, let me first of all explain to you. We can say that, so the variance of the portfolio is equal to 38.54 is z minus z bar whole square into probability and summation of the same. Okay, it is z minus z bar into probability and summation of the same. How z is calculated? It is weight of x into x, weight of y into y. That is the way the z is calculated. Z bar, that is the mean value, is 6.4%. And that 6.4% can be calculated like this. It is a weight into x bar, weight into y bar. That is the way the z bar is calculated. So when you will simplify this equation, you'll get the formula that we have written. So derivation of the formula starts like this: variance of the portfolio is equal to z minus z bar whole square into probability and summation of the same. Fine. Now what is the value of the z? Value of the z is wx into return of x. So I am assigning x variable to it, plus z bar, plus weight of y into return of y. This is what we understand is the z minus z bar. How to compute z bar? It is weight of x into x bar minus, plus weight of y into y bar. So this is z minus z bar whole raised to 2 into probability and summation of the same. This is what we understand is z, and this is what we understand is z bar, that is, say, 6.4%. This is the way the derivation starts. Now you open this bracket. So what will happen? We understand that, say, over here it is weight of x into return of x plus weight of y into return of y minus, when you open the bracket, this is negative, this is positive, so it will become negative. That is weight of x into x bar. Again, this is negative, this is positive, so it will become negative, minus weight of y into y bar whole raised to 2 into probability and summation of the same. Okay. Now, what happens at say, we can say that this weight of x into x and this is weight of x and x bar. I take it on one side. So I'm writing it like this. Weight of x into x minus weight of x into x bar plus weight of y into y minus weight of y minus y bar whole raised to 2 into probability and summation of the same. Now we can take this weight of x common. Okay, so what will happen over here? Weight of x is taken common, in bracket I'm writing x minus x bar. Again, this weight of y is taken common. So over here, weight of y is taken common, in bracket I'm writing y minus y bar whole raised to 2 into probability and summation of the same. That is the way I do the simplification. Okay, now next, what happens at friends? We can take this as, let us say A, this is taken as B, so A plus B whole square. What will happen? It is A square plus 2AB plus B square. That is the way we can have the simplification. So I'm writing it like this, A square. So what I'm writing over here, WX square x minus x bar whole square. This is a square plus b square. So it is wy square y minus y bar whole square plus 2ab. So 2 into a is what? Wx x minus x bar b. That is wy into y minus y bar. Dear students, we understand that say there may be a change in the multiplication sequence, it is not going to change the answer. Now when I do a square, that is this. B square, that is this. 2ab, that is this. Now to that the common multiplier is summation probability A. So over here it is multiplied with summation, that is summation probability, that is a common multiplier to all. That is what I am mentioning over here. Okay, now listen carefully. This is wx square and this value is nothing else but it is the variance of x, this value. So I'm writing over here variance of x plus wy square. Again, this value is nothing else but it is the variance of y. Y minus y bar whole square into probability and summation of that. That is what say, we did for like Mrs. Tendulkar. So summation y square plus 2 into weight of x into weight of y. And dear students, this is the formula for the covariance. Covariance between x and y is calculated as x minus x bar into y minus y bar into probability and summation of the same. That is what we have is the covariance between x and y. Okay. Now, to explain you further calculation, I just need to remind you, recollect you the formula of R, correlation coefficient. Formula of R correlation coefficient is covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation x into standard deviation y. This is a formula of R. Now the covariance is calculated as, that is covariance between x and y is calculated as product of this three, that is R into standard deviation X into standard deviation Y. So multiplication of this three is the covariance of X and Y. So this is replaced with R into standard deviation X into standard deviation Y. So I'm rewriting the equation. Wx square sigma x square plus wy square sigma y square plus 2 into, now this is replaced with the R, okay, correlation coefficient, into standard deviation x, standard deviation y, wx, wy. Remaining things as it is, just that is, remember the formula properly. I write the formula like this: wx square sigma x square plus wy square sigma y square plus 2 into R into product of this 2, wx sigma x. Again, product of this 2, wy sigma y. That is the way we have the variance of the portfolio. And once we make the computation of the variance, and then under root of the same is the standard deviation. So now we are continuing with our answer. Method number 2, in that, so the return of the portfolio, that we already have done it with a simple weighted average. Now standard deviation of the portfolio, for that, so we are required to compute first of all variance. For variance of the portfolio, we have understood the formula: wx square sigma x square plus wy square sigma y square plus 2 into R into wx sigma x, wy sigma y. So for that, so you have to apply that formula. Now for applying that formula, we need to have the value of the R. R means the correlation coefficient. For value of the R, again three things are required. One is the covariance required. Second is the standard deviation of X is required. Standard deviation of Y is required. Standard deviation of X and Y we already have. So now we are required to compute only the covariance. So in order to compute the standard deviation of the portfolio with the second method, working note number 1 will be covariance, working note number 2 will be correlation coefficient, working note number 3 will be calculation of the variance of the portfolio, and then finally we'll compute the standard deviation of the portfolio. That is the way we are supposed to compute standard deviation of the portfolio. Now friends, for the purpose of calculation of the covariance, we require the values of the x minus x bar that we will take from here. We'll require the y minus y bar that we will take over here. And probability information is of course same. That is the way the covariance will be calculated first of all. So read on heading: calculation of risk of portfolio, comma, for investment in 2 shares. That is in 2 securities. If it is more than 2, we are going to discuss that later on. In that, working note number 1, calculation of the covariance between X and Y. Column number 1 is probability. Column number 2 is X minus X bar. You have to be careful to see that, say, whether it is positive or negative. Y minus Y bar, again same, that is, you should be conscious enough to understand it. Then X minus X bar into Y minus Y bar into probability. Summation of that says the covariance. Then working note number 2 will be R and so on. So column number 1 is probability 0.40, 0.20 and 0.40. Then X minus X bar is 7.8 positive, that we already have found about. Then it is 19.2 negative. Then it is 1.8 positive. So next is 7.4 positive, 8.4 positive. Then 11.6 negative. Now the final answer is x1 is x4, 7.8 into 7.4 into 0.40. Then be careful, it is negative 19.2 into positive 8.4 into 0.20. In the last case it is 1.8 into negative 11.6 into 0.4. That is the way the covariance would be calculated. So 7.8 into 7.4 into 0.4, that is 23.088, 19.2 negative into 8.4 positive into 0.2, that is 32.256. into 11.6 negative into 0.4, that is 8.352 negative. So 17.52 is negative. That is the covariance between x and y. Now based on this, we can compute the correlation coefficient. So it is working note number 2. Calculation of R, correlation coefficient. It is covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. And dear students, understanding this second method is very important, because many a times you will be provided with the only information with which you can apply the second method and not the first method. So the numerator is negative 17.52 divided by standard deviation of x and standard deviation of y. Standard deviation of x is 9.9679 and standard deviation of y is 9.4784. So here it is 9.9679 into 9.4784. is negative. So the final answer is negative 0.1854. That is the way the R correlation coefficient is formed. Next, calculation of variance of the portfolio. That is working note number 3. It will be found as Wx squared sigma x squared plus Wy squared sigma y squared plus 2 into R into Wx sigma x Wy sigma y. Okay, so now Wx squared, what is weight of x? It is 0.50. What is weight of y? It is again 0.50. Into again variance of x and variance of y, we already have found about. Variance of x is 99.36 and variance of y is 89.84. So here it is 99.36 and this is 89.84 plus 2 into R is negative 0.1854 into weight of x 0.50 into weight of y 0.50 once again into standard deviation of x, standard deviation y. That is under root of 99.36, 9.9679, and under root of 89.84, that is 9.4784. That is, once again, we already have found it. That is 89.84.
Okay.
So now we are required to simplify this equation. In that, first of all, I am doing answer for this component. Square of 0.5 is 0.25 into 99.36. So 24.84 plus, simplifying this, 0.5 raised to 2 into 89.84. So it is 22.46 minus. Why? Because this correlation coefficient is negative. So 2 into 0.1854 negative into 0.5 into 0.5 into 9.9679 into 9.4784. That comes to negative 8.7583. Number of times the students are having a point that, sir, instead of writing this equation, R into the sigma x and sigma y, can we write that's the covariance? The answer is yes. In a way, that say whatever the covariance that we have found over here, 17.52, that you can directly multiply over here. That is 2 into 17.52 negative into weight of x into weight of y. That is also the way you can do it, because basically this is nothing else but the product of this 3 only. However, usually, say, we are provided with the correlation coefficient format, that is the information, so I am doing answer like this. But if at all you have a point that I want to do in this way, can I? The answer is yes. So 2 into 17.52 negative into 0.5 into 0.5, you get the same answer, 8.76. But every time this information may not be available, and correlation coefficient information may be available, so I have shown you answer like this. Okay. And based on that, say, we make the calculation of answer. Now, dear students, all of you are smart enough to understand that, say, in the addition or subtraction, the sequence is, say, not going to make any difference. So you may show this as first or last, you may show this as first, last, in between, anywhere. That is not going to make any difference because addition sign is there. But just you have to make sure, of course, that's in the multiplication, you don't have any mistake. Otherwise, the answer would be wrong. Okay. Coming back to our point, 24.84 plus 22.46 minus 8.7583. That comes to 38.5417. This is, dear students, variance of the portfolio. Once we have the variance of the portfolio, then last answer is standard deviation. It is calculated as root of the variance of the portfolio. So root of 38.5417. That comes to 6.2082. That is the way standard deviation of the portfolio can be found. So you can see that, so this answer is matching with the answer that, so we already have found, 38.54 and 6.2081%. So let us have a small summary of this entire answer. Dear students, we understand information is provided to us, say there are 3 investors. First investor who has made investment only in X, second only in Y, and third is in the combination of X and Y. Investor who has made only in X, we compute the return and risk, say for like that investor, taking into account the proportion in which investment is made and taking into account the return. That is the way, say we make the computation of the return and risk for Mr. Tendulkar. That's very simple. Exactly the same thing is required to be done for Mrs. Tendulkar. Again, that is, say, not something which is very difficult. The third is Master Tendulkar. In that we understand, here in this question, there are two methods by which you can do answer. Method number one, you take into account the proportion in which investment is made, return of the individual sector, that is say, return in each of the situation, weighted average. When you make the computation of the return, you take the proportion in which investment is made and the return in that situation from that security. Proportion return, that is the way we do answer. Then routine, variance of the portfolio and standard deviation. Nothing is great in that case. Second method, in that so the return of the portfolio is again very simple. It is only simple weighted average formula is required to be applied. You just have to see the proportion in which investment is made and the return in that situation, and with that so the weighted average, so the return of the portfolio is found. Then the most important part of the question comes. The most important part of the question is, let's say you compute the risk of the portfolio taking into account so the proportion in which you have made investment, risk of the individual security, and most importantly, the correlation coefficient that say these securities have with one another. The reason behind that is, say we have to take into account that say what kind of performance that one security will have when the other security is falling down, or if at all that security is also going up. That kind of correlation coefficient, say between the returns or among the, that is the securities return, is very important for us to find. If at all both the securities are moving in the same direction every time, when the returns are going up or when the returns are going down, then in that case definitely risk of the portfolio is high. Why? Because in one situation you will have very good return and in other situation will have very poor return. Instead of that, if at all you make investment in securities, say which say compensate the poor return of the other security with good return, then in that case, say your risk of the portfolio will be less. And in that case, so you should select the securities, say which have preferably negative relationship. So you should not make investment in securities which like umbrella and that is the raincoat combination. Instead of that, say you should make investment in securities. One of them is dealing in cotton and another is dealing in woolen. So we make the computation of the correlation coefficient. We have understood a small example that making investment in different securities, that number is not so important, but investing in the different sectors is important. That is the way we are supposed to compute the risk of the portfolio. For that, so this is a simple formula which we are required to apply. So far we have discussed only two securities, and in the coming examples we are going to understand say more than two securities as well. So we have done a detailed working: covariance, correlation coefficient, range of the correlation coefficient is negative 1 to positive 1, negative 1 is the perfect negative, positive 1 is perfect positive, 0 independent, 0 to negative 1 is negative relationship, 0 to 1 is positive relationship. This is the way the variance and standard deviation is found.